Welcome back to my channel, everyone. My name is Mish, and today, if you can't tell by my Bob Ross shirt, my paintbrush, and my easel, that today I'm going to be disclaimer, I'm not a very good artist. Two of my best pieces are actually in the background, but it took me a long time and a lot of focus on the Bob Ross tutorial that I was following in order to get to those to look the way they do, so don't expect that much talent to come out. This is really purely just for ASMR purposes. I still haven't even decided what I'm going to be painting today. So, that's the vibe we're going for. Alright. Alright. So, here I have Bob Ross himself's liquid white. So this is an oil-based white paint that goes on first onto the canvas, and mine needs to be mixed quite a bit. Okay. Now I've got so much on the brush. So if I put this down first, it creates a base. my colors will blend much more easily over top. It's not as thin as it usually is because it's dried up over time. I should probably get some paint thinner and thin that out, but I'm just gonna cover the canvas. A thin layer. And I'm gonna try to get the bottom edge too. And try not to get any on my floor. This is going to be an adventure for everyone involved, if I'm being honest. I have not painted a painting that I've liked in quite a while. Quite a while. I've painted a few times in the last year or so. I've painted a few times in the last year or so, but I haven't been very fond of how any of the paintings came. Always your own worst critic, though. And I'm also the type of person, this is not a good thing, but I am self-aware. I'm the type of person where if I'm not good at it right away, I have a hard time doing it, you know? So I'm gonna be using some water mixable oil paints today, because oil paint is normally only mixable with paint thinner. And for both my own health, my kitty's health, and how toxic paint thinner is, I decide to use water mixable oil. I'm not exactly sure what they do to the chemical compound to make the oil paint mix with water, but I ain't really question it at this point. So I think what I'm gonna do is try to do some kind of sunset. So I'm gonna start with some alizarin crimson. Just like good old Bob himself would use. And just get a little dab onto my little mixing. I'm also gonna take some French ultramarine, and I'm gonna pop a little bit of that into my palette as well. Okay, I might need a little more of this than I do of the red though. Okay. So I'm gonna start. I'm gonna take, let's see, what brush do I want? I think I'm gonna take this brush. I'm gonna dip it in some water so I can thin it out. And grab a little bit of that blue. Okay, now let's get the blue nice and. Gonna start in this edge, and I'm just gonna make some little X's. Okay, now I wanna get some deeper blue up in the corner here. And I do want to, let's see, adjust this. Okay, so I'm just going to lightly blend that blue using little X motions, leaving some spots with darker in the sky. I'm probably gonna take this about halfway down. But I'm gonna grab a little more blue. Little more blue. Just to keep her interesting. Let's get this nice and spread out, okay? That's as far down as I'm going to go on the canvas with the blue. But I do want some spots to be very blue. Like that. So I'm going to just add those in. And not blend them out as much. So I want right here to have a nice blue spot. And then just kind of blend that out. Okay. So now that we've got some blue on the left side, I'm gonna make this equally as dark on some parts of the right side. I'm just gonna pull that in certain ways, okay. So now I'm gonna rinse that blue off of my brush. And use that same brush and grab a little bit of the crimson and just kind of mix a little bit of this blue red. You only need a little. A little goes such a long way with red. Tiniest bit of the red. And just now it's getting a little too muddy. I don't really want it to look this blended between the blue and the red. I think I need to not water down the red and just plop that. There we go. That looks better. I like that more. And just plop some vibrant red spots into where that blue kind of disperses. So let's blend out to get that gradual blue to red sky I'm looking for. Now I do think I need to add back in some blue to get it to blend better. I'm not digging this so far. Like I said, it just looks a little muddy. beautiful thing about painting is you can kind of just work in layers. So what I'm going to do is work back in this blue. And kind of just pull it through. Some of these areas where it got lost. Let's just add back in some more blue element to our sky. Okay, that's better. And now when I go to add in my red elements, I'm gonna be much choppier with my red. And I'm just not going to blend it as much. And then you'll see when I pull across the page, whatever. But it'll look less muddy when I go to spread this out. Is this purple? Kind of what I'm trying to avoid, right? So let's see if I can. This brush may. Yeah, there we go. A clean brush to kind of just pull some of that around. And then blend. Okay. And I am also going to take just a little bit of yellow. And in my little mixing station, I'm going to take my brush that I've been using to blend instead. Onto a towel. Okay. And I'm gonna grab a little bit of yellow and mix with some red. I'm trying to aim for a orange. With mixing in the orange is not to do too much blending, because we don't want to end up with green in our sky. So I'm just gonna very lightly, and I already have green occurring, right? So now I'm just going to rinse that again. Yellow into where we just mixed that red with the water last time. Okay, silence. Just on the edge of the red sections. Okay, so that is kind of how I envision this. Not really, I'm not gonna lie to you. I think that I definitely had a different vision of how that would come out in my head, but I'm not gonna spend too much time trying to make it perfect, you know, but I am just gonna go in with some red. And going in with red is gonna ensure that the yellow mixes with the red, not the blue. Not the blue. Okay. I'm gonna call that to be an okay sky. Not my best, not my worst. I do think that coming back in with some bright blue, kind of just dab on in there where it got a little muted. I still haven't decided what I'm even gonna put in the bottom half of this. No, I'm pretty bad at mountains. And I say that because they piss me off. Every time I paint a freaking mountain, I get so annoyed so quickly. And like, I just don't enjoy painting mountains. So I don't think I'm going to include mountains in this baby. Purely for my own sanity. So guilty of spending way too much time trying to get things to be perfect. So again, not my fave, not the worst. We're gonna move on before I spend way too much time on this. So now this dirty little brush goes into the needs to be cleaned pile. And I'm gonna grab another clean brush. This brush has been well loved. Very well loved, and you might hear my kitty meowing at the door. She also is well loved. So I want to create kind of a brown green to just into the background. So I'm gonna take some red. I'm just gonna use that little pot that we had used in the red before. And now I'm gonna take some green, and this is Viridian Hue. I'm going to take Viridian Hue and pop that into a new little section here. And let's see, I think I also want to add in a little bit of blue, but just a teeny bit. Just a teeny bit. So I'm just going to pop that into blue section, so I can just dab a tiny bit with the brush. So I'm mostly gonna use green, so I'm gonna mix it where I put the green. So I'm just going to grab some blue, a good chunk. Mix that into the green. And grab red. There we go. And that's the dark mush I'm going for. So this is just going to be the background, so it's not important what the shapes look like. So I'm just going to dab into the back. And all that's important is that it kind of looks like trees. This isn't the darkest background I've made. And it is mixing in with that white. So I do need a lot more paint on this than I initially expected. So let's just throw a big blob of green in there. Now, unfortunately, I do not have actual oil paints, nor am I going to be beating the devil out of my paintbrush. So that is one of my favorite parts of Bob Ross videos. But I'm gonna load up that paintbrush with a lot of paint so that when I go to, there we go, that's much better of what I actually wanted to happen. And I don't want this to look too, perfect. I say that as if it looks too perfect right now. But you know what I mean? I don't want it to look like a pattern. Nature has patterns, yes. But nature's a lot more random. Again, we just want colors, shapes, and texture, because this is just the background. I want to pull this down nice and far to probably about here. So this is going to be like the evergreen line. Evergreen trees. Okay. Good. So this interesting color is that. Now I'm gonna mix in some more red and give some dimension. Have some different blend of color in the back. Have a more brown shaded tree over here in the back. And then some more brown up the middle, and some more brown up the side here. Now I definitely got a lot of red in that one over on the right, so I'm gonna try to mimic some symmetry. Okay. So that's gonna be my background. Let's make sure that this is even all the way across. Okay. Now, what do I want to do down here? I could do like a lake. I kind of feel like I always do water. But I think it's a tried and true. It's because I love it, so I end up always putting it in all my paintings. I'll Although I don't really have another brush that I think will help me with a water section. Let's see. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and let's see if I can uncrunch this. Some of these are a little crunchy, because they dried with just a tiny bit of paint left in them. Tiny bit of paint left in them. So I'm gonna grab blue, and I'm just gonna mix. The charm. If I could get this out, geez. Just a teeny bit, and this is titanium white. And I'm also gonna pop some green into a pan because, actually, no, I'm not. I think that's blue green enough where I just want this blue to mix with the white and create a nice lighter blue. And of course it is going to mix in with our liquid white that's in the back. And if you wonder why I keep putting some things off of the screen, it's because it's where the microphone is set up today. So I've got a lot of paint on here, and I'm just going to drag inward. I don't really care about accidentally painting. Okay. So I am going to grab more water, but I need to make sure, because it looks like the liquid white has dried. Took too long. Normally, I will just kind of race through paintings to try to make sure the liquid white doesn't dry. When you're filming ASMR, you have to pause for loud noises and trains and all those kinds of things. So I'm just gonna take some water and kind of thin out my paint. And my water is kind of dirty. So this is going to be kind of hilarious, I'm not even going to lie. It might mess up the entire thing because I have done that before. With really dirty water, I just like went to go blend in my lake that I had created, and I turned the whole thing green. Like a brown water. And I loved the rest of the painting, and I was like, are you kidding? But, as Bobby says, there's no mistakes. As I just grab some green on accident, there's no mistakes, only happy accidents. So if we accidentally end up with a green lake, we will just, deal with it, you know? We'll deal, just fine, we'll be okay. We will be okay. I think the main thing I want to avoid is scraping my brush against the metal, because that's jarring for me, and I'm not even picking up what the microphone is hearing, so I want to avoid that. Okay, so now that I have this gap where the sun is supposedly shining in the middle, plop that into my dirty water, and I'm gonna uncrunch this little guy. Uncrunch him. Grab some water. Uncrunch him. Okay, so now I just want to use some of this water. Okay, so now that I did that, I want to grab another dry clean brush, then I'm gonna uncrunch. There is no uncrunching this one, look at that. So sad. Okay, that did not do what I wanted it to. So I think what I'm gonna do then is just take any and all paint off of this brush, rub that on my cardboard, and just pretend that this is a clean, dry brush. And if I... there we go. I'm trying not to make that scrapey noise that drives me absolutely wild. So let's just... But now, I don't want to get rid of all that blue that we had. That was a really pretty blue, so I'm gonna go back in and add more vibrant blue back into our outsides. Like so. And I'm just gonna pull that. We're gonna pull that in, and just pull that in. Now I like the way Okay. So now that I like the way that this turned out, I'm just gonna do that and then just grab a fan brush to kind of blend her out again. Okay, so now that I have that doing what I wanted to do, I need to finish up my shoreline. So I want to return with something close to this color, but a little more brown. So let's mix together. Muddy, but I am gonna add just a teeny tiny bit of yellow because we want this to be more brown. I'm actually going to use yellow ochre, which is a little bit more of a brown toned yellow anyway. So let's, if I could open this. Jeez, who closed this? And it was me, I closed it. So, and I'll just pop that into that little pan where I had mixed some paint before. And get that cap back on somehow. You know how every ASMR just like plays with the cap and pretends to put it on 1,000 times before actually putting it on? I do that on purpose and on accident. Okay, so I'm gonna grab this brush that we used for our, I believe, our lake there, and I'm just gonna use that to mix the green, red, and blue together. So now we've got a color very close to what the back trees are. But now I'm gonna add in that yellow ochre. Now, how do I get this to be more brown is the question. I think red would make it more brown. But I like this color, so I think what I'm gonna do is add in some foliage using this color, because that way I get to use this color since I like it so much. I'm just gonna dab in a nice bit of foliage. So, a train went by. But I think that I successfully made the brown that I was looking for by adding that red into the color I was using for this tree. So now I'm going to just dab in a waterline here. I do want to be careful not to get my paintbrush in the white. And I can always bring it down, that's another thing. Okay, let's make a clear difference between where these trees and this begin. And you can pull down as far as you need to. So it's kind of curved. Not my intention, but it's where we are, and then we're just gonna drag down. So it kinda looks like a ledge. Now, I have seen many people do the reflection into the water, but I don't know if I want to trust myself with that at this very moment. I think I would rather have a pretty water that I like, then not enjoy it. So what I'm gonna do now is get that brush all watered up and now I'm gonna wanna paint in some highlights and I want to make a light green and yellow as well. So I think that the rest of the painting is going to be highlights and mixtures of different greens. I'll just start by making a uncrunchy yellowy green. There we go. And I do need to get a good amount of that on the brush. And what I'm going to do is kind of use the same little mixing spot to keep mixing my color. I might actually want this to dry a little bit before adding in more because it's kind of just blending, it's not really sticking on top. Or I need just more paint. Yeah. Let's just grab some more paint and kind of move in here. Now, because these are water mixable oils, they don't act exactly like oil paint. I am just going to attempt to treat it like oil paint. And then add more yellow. And then play around with some of this very yellow green. And I need a lot more yellow. That green just eats up the yellow. So what I'm gonna do is pop a bunch of yellow into that butt of pan. Wipe off the excess and make a very yellow green up here. And then I'm gonna use this to make some like bushes. And kind of just hide where this tree line is. Okay, so again, mixing the greens together so nothing is consistently one specific green, because as you know, nature is gonna have many, many shades of green in its bushes. I'm gonna then scoop and make another very yellow green. Boop, boop, boop. Okay. So there's my yellow green bushes that go over where that kind of dirt area starts now. I'm not super happy with how this looks just yet, so let's see what else I can do. I think adding just straight up yellow is going to help my cause. I don't really know. I think I should follow a Bob Ross tutorial on my channel. That would be really fun. Okay, so now let's just try to get some yellow. Yeah, that's not really sticking how I want it to. This just looks kind of muddy. So I am just going to try to get some yellow spots. But I think I need to wait for this layer to dry a little bit. With oil, you can just add a little paint thinner, and that will make the paint stick more easily. But like I said, this is water mixable oil, so it's not going to act exactly like oil paint normally would, which can be a little frustrating, I'm not gonna lie. I'm already not the worst painter too, so it doesn't really help my cause. It's all for funsies, you know. So I do have this like lighter green that I can kind of dot in there too. So it does look super muddy, I'm not gonna lie. I think I could have done better with more foliage here. But, you know, do this again, don't worry, and maybe each time I can get just a little bit better. But anyway, here's the finished product. Let me know if you like this type of video, and I can definitely do it again. But remember, you are worthy, and to give as much love as you'd like to receive. Thanks for watching.